You know, I think I have the most success, and what I feel my success is when I come into the studio and I'm able to stay in the studio all day without leaving, whether it's 8 hours or 10 hours, 12 hours, and just work with my music on. I love listening to avant-garde music and things like that. So what happens is I'll just go into a piece and it's almost like I'm not really thinking about what I'm doing. I'm just going with the flow of what I feel, of what I, you know, what I want to do, and whatever colors are available that day. And then sometimes I work with two or three colors, and sometimes I'll try to work with every color that I have. But mostly, maybe over the last year or so, I've been trying to, you know, edit the amount of colors I use. But it always comes to me as far as it's almost like it just happens, like you say, organically. It just happens, and those are the ones I have the most success with. When I sketch a piece out or draw something out, I really end up changing it. You're supposed to be seeing a lot of vivid color. You're seeing something that is what I like to say is creating beauty. The title of the piece is In the Crepuscule with Nelly, and I relate a lot of my work to jazz, and that's a monk tune, and just from the colors and things like that. So mainly it's probably for me to give you maybe a cue with the title, and then you can, you know, go from there with what you feel about it. Okay, I'm married to Marion Hayden, the bassist, and I always tell people, you know, when they mention other bass players, I always say, well, you know, I say, you know who I'm married to? You know, she's the best on the planet. The oldest son now is working on his master's, and he's also working with CCS as a community coordinator, I believe, and he's working with the DIA as a community outreach, and he's also working on his master's at Wayne State, and he's working on his master's in drawing. The youngest one is, matter of fact, he'll be 20 in a week, May 7th. His name is Tariq. He's a drummer, and he's majors in music. He's majoring in music at U of M. So we stay pretty busy. This is an old fire station built in 1902, and I believe it is historical. I bought a few years ago, actually in 2008, and we had maybe looked at it several years before that, and someone owned it. I think they were a ceramicist, and at that point, I guess it became vacant, and they wanted to sell it. So I bought it in 2008, and so since then, I've been dividing my time between, painting, doing my artwork, and working on the building, and trying to keep it, livable. We went to this place on Goree Island called the Door of No Return, which was an old slave castle where they managed to bring slaves to for transport. And so they called it the Door of No Return because once you left that door, you either went to one of the Americas, you either went to South America, Central America, or North America. Before that, you know, like I said, before my trip to Senegal, I had been, you know, using doors as far as some of the icons in my work. This piece is a more of a reoccurring piece. It's almost like, it's not like a nightmare or anything, but it's just something that just fascinates me as far as where my creativity is now. And I often wonder that if I were still in Africa or somewhere in Africa, or if, you know, this thing hadn't happened, where would I be with my creativity? I kind of sell works kind of sporadically. It kind of comes and goes. I don't have a specific person that's out there just pushing to sell my work. I'm probably like the main one. And you know, as an artist, I try to be here in the studio and work. And usually what happens, I think good things happen if I'm here working. And I think that it's not easy to make the work. I don't think it's easy. I don't think it's easy for anybody anywhere. Art isn't being supported, you know, as we all know, by the state or by the government. I believe in New York they had like that 1% for art. So if a building was being constructed, 1% of that, however much the building cost, went to buy art for the building. So we don't have that here in Michigan for something just to like supplement, you know, artists that are making art.